After watching the four shorts, I went back and read the four short stories जहाँ से ये निकली primarily for context. And I have some thoughts. Come, let's discuss. There will be spoilers. Netflix ki Ray Anthology is a series of four one-hour-long movies based on short stories by Satyajit Ray, divided among three directors: Srijit Mukherjee, Abhishek Chaubey, and Vasan Bala. All four are entirely separate shorts with nothing in common except Satyajit Ray. So feel free to watch in any order you like. Which is how I'm going to now talk about them, because I'm starting with the fourth one, my favorite of the lot, Spotlight by Vasan Bala. Probably deviating the most from the source material compared to the rest of the films, Vasan Bala's Spotlight, written by Niren Bhatt, is a study in millennial existential crises, culminating in a climax sequence which soars super high, an unbridled flight of fancy. Meet Vic, played by Harshvardhan Kapoor. He is a popular mainstream movie actor with millions of fans. He's now at that point in his career where fame is beginning to annoy him. He's got enough money to now desire creative satisfaction. He's weird and quirky and entitled in ways famous performers are occasionally known to be. He requires constant looking after because there's very little now standing between him and deliberate self-destruction. On a shoot schedule, he crosses paths with a jatha of bhakts in town following Didi, a mysterious spiritual / cult leader who's staying in the same hotel as him. The movie now tells you more details about Didi and what the fuss is about by going further into Vic's psyche and drawing parallels between his life and hers. We don't actually meet her right until the end, but with Vic, we learn that she's not that much different from him. I will say this here though, these parallels to question what Spotlight means and who deserves it, they tend to get a little too convenient. I understand these are two individuals that are not that different from each other in terms of how they live their famous lives, but kuch references, things they both say, which you'll see when you see, fit in too comfortably, which I didn't like, kyunki the film is about discomfort, hysteria, mass, nasha. Harshvardhan Kapoor is playing what his character from AK vs. AK would be 2 to 3 years in the future after he's seen conventional mainstream success, only to realize he doesn't want it. He's dating a woman who seems to be an actor in Punjabi cinema only because he likes living vicariously through her. She's real. Chandan Roy Sanyal is just excellent as his manager / friend Robbie, trying to douse fires before they ignite, knowing full well what Vic's man-child ass is capable of doing. The entire short is riddled with Ray references, some obvious, some not so much. In a Vic hallucination, his mother appears as Didi because he doesn't quite know what Didi looks like, so perhaps in his head, she shares a face with the only woman who's ever exerted any amount of control over his life. The mother sits on a throne and rattles off names of Ray movies, Kapurush, Mahapurush, Joy Baba, Felunath. Lekin, my favorite reference is when it is revealed that Didi is a young woman, probably in her late 20s, Radhika Madan turns up, bottom half Ghagra, top half Song of the Little Road t-shirt, Mane Pathir Panchali. And what an actor she is. This is when Vic and Didi become one. They're not just people who are fighting for the spotlight, but they are young people who've seen too much at too young an age and are lost in the worlds they themselves created. Both are looking for an out, but not entirely willing to give up the real comforts afforded to them by their fake charm. Sneha Khanwalkar's banger, Nan Matakka, written by Ankur Tiwari, sung by Sneha Pandit in a disarming baby voice, appears now. It is my absolute favorite part of this four-part series, complementing perfectly Vasan Bala and Niren Bhatt's attempts at magic realism. Spotlight is eventually about many things: glory, popular culture, religion, fanaticism. And also, if women didn't have to live in fear and were simply allowed to achieve our full potential, how different our world and the world at large might be. Ray would be proud, I think. Now, going one step back, Niren Bhatt is also credited as writer for Abhishek Chaubey's Hangama Kyun Hai Barpa. This one, in a complete 180, sticks largely to the source material. The setting, characters, conflict, they're pretty much exactly how Satyajit Ray wrote them in his story Baran Bhomekir Bayaram. Sorry for the pronunciation. Muzaffar Ali is a famous Shire / Ghazal singer in the late 80s, early 90s, back when important folks still traveled via train. On a journey, he meets Aslam Beg, urf Jenga Pehlwan, who's exactly the kind of chatty co-passenger he doesn't want. Kyunki Muzaffar Ali is a showman. He only likes attention on himself. Anyone else telling their story is of little to no interest to him. For him, every mirror is an opportunity to practice public speaking, and everyone doing a double take to look at him is a fan. Lekin, soon he realizes he has met Aslam Beg on a similar train journey once way before he was famous, and what had transpired between them then. Beg, on the other hand, remembers nothing. Having Manoj Bajpayee and Gajraj Rao riff off of each other is a delight I did not know I needed in my life. While for us, the story unfolds via Musafir, hence we're in the know because Aslam doesn't know, but yet he's such an important part of the narrative, there's also dramatic irony at play, which makes the climactic payoff way more satisfying. Once again, here Niren Bhatt brings in magic realism. Manoj Pawa appears as a store owner where people return items that they've stolen to clear their conscience. A character you'd expect in a Douglas Adams book, frankly. In his store, there's stolen Satyajit Ray stories, there's Lord Mountbatten's pajamas. When you hear of Musafir Ali's kleptomania, one of the first things he returns is a clapping monkey toy, stolen from a rich kid in his childhood, which could very well be the same kid from Ray's silent 11-minute short, jiska naam hai 2. वो YouTube पर है, जाके देखना. Ray's original story explains how Raju afforded a first class ticket back in the day before he was Musafir Ali, which the movie doesn't explain, which was a little jarring, not gonna lie. Like, Jack and Rose are gonna meet on the Titanic, right? So we have to know where they both came from, how they both got there. But while passenger C in the story, who becomes Aslam Beg here, only liked black tea, a term which jogs the protagonist's mind, black tea might not be that much of a differentiator anymore. In the movie, it needed to be more specific. Hence, black tea becomes Chai Numi Basra, which immediately are three most memorable words Musafir has probably like not heard anywhere else ever. So dare I say, the movie, the writing slightly even improves on the original story. Hangama Kyun Hai Barpa is a delightfully quirky film with Manoj Bajpayee and Gajraj Rao bringing their A-game amidst beautifully designed sets, blurring lines constantly between real and imaginary, all narrated in a sweet as honey mix of Hindi and delightful Urdu. Before I go to the other two, casual reminder to subscribe to my channel for my personal happiness. Thank you. Now to move further back towards the two Srijit Mukherjee films, both written by Siraj Ahmed, Forget Me Not and Bahurupia. Bahurupia is easily the weakest film of the lot. I'd go as far as to call it unwatchable. A regular office employee moonlights as a makeup artist because passion, I guess. And when his grandmother dies, leaving him money and mind space to finally start thinking about life because now he's rich, he goes out of his way to use his makeup skills to take badla from everyone who has recently wronged him until that feeling takes over his entire being. K.K. Menon, a phenomenal effortless actor, is weighed down by the clunkiest dialogue in cinema history. How is he to react with compassion if an actor opposite him is saying, kisi ne 40 saal pehle condom istemal kar liya hota to ye din dekhna nahi padta? How is he to create catharsis when the woman he fancies, an actor he does makeup for, is mouthing, if you want to fuck me, you can fuck me anytime? Among other flaws, Bahurupia fails in its ambition to go beyond what Ray was saying in the short Bahurupi, that it completely crosses over into pretension for pretension's sake. Neither able to provide the thrill of a coherent mystery nor an exploration of Godman as Ray was wont to do. There's also just laziness. K.K. Menon transforms into an exact replica of another actor without us knowing how. A convict on the loose shown in wanted posters from the very start is so clearly K.K. Menon in bad makeup, you know that he's going to become this convict at some point, and by the time it gets there, your patience has worn thin. The reason why I came to Bahurupia and Forget Me Not last is because I have the least to say about these two. While Bahurupia was, like I said, borderline unwatchable, despite actors like K.K. Menon and Rajesh Sharma, it's the first one of the series, Forget Me Not, starring my absolute favorite Ali Fazal, which just broke my heart. Ali plays Ipsit, a corporate bro rising very fast in his career. One look at his attitude, body language, you can tell this guy is as self-centered as they come and probably cheats on his wife. He pulls all kinds of stunts in shareholder meetings with the cocky confidence of being a young boss and a conventionally good-looking man surrounded by subordinates. In his manic rise to one professional triumph after another, he's lost sight of actual relationships with friends, family, staff and people in general, and is in for a very rude awakening. Ali is one of the finest actors of Hindi cinema, but like K.K. Menon, he's had to mouth words like did I put my dick in your vagina? I paraphrase. And sure, out of context, this line might sound bizarre, but trust me, even when it appears in the film right towards the end, there is no place for it. A line put in the dialogue for shock, but only ends up creating cringe. Not to say Ali doesn't try. He has a bit of an accent going. Every line is delivered with very good timing, but even in his able hands, Ipsit is reduced to a farcical caricature. Unfortunately, cringe is what Forget Me Not serves up in max quantity. Another talented actor, Shweta Basu Prasad, playing a crazy ex-lover stereotype, is borderline an affront to the original story Bipin Chaudhary's Smriti Brahm and raised female characters in general. The part she plays, it doesn't exist in the original. Not to say that writers and filmmakers shouldn't make stories their own. Vasan Bala added Didi, an entire reimagination. But when your short is part of a series which is titled Ray, wouldn't you think your characters might be 2021 recreations, but from the same mold Ray had successfully mastered? It's puzzling because clearly Srijit Mukherjee, Siraj Ahmed, this team are big Ray fans, as evident in a scene where Ipsit talks to his building's guard. Peeche jitne residents ke naam likhe hue hain board par, unme you'll spot Tarini Charan Chattopadhyay, Maganlal Meghraj, Victor Perumal, Manmohan Mitra, all Ray characters from other stories and films. Anyway, coming back to my original point, watch the anthology on Netflix in whichever way you prefer and don't give up agar ek ya do achhi nahi lage. Char hai, dekhiye, kuch to raas aayi jayega. Aur agar itna lamba chada video raas aa gaya, to please subscribe kar le channel ko. Thank you.